Welcome to the April 2019 edition of the Microsoft 365 Update. This month, we'll cover new and updated services to help you meet your compliance requirements, manage security policies, and reach more audiences with your content. As always, everything I talk about is fully documented in the transcript and resources guide at aka.ms/m365update-blog. Many of you no doubt have to demonstrate business impact for the work you do. And I'm no different. While I really enjoy putting these videos together, creating them takes a team, albeit small, of very dedicated individuals and professional-grade video production facilities, both of which come at a cost. With that as context, I used Microsoft Forms to create a short survey I'm hoping you'll take a few minutes to complete. It has some questions that will allow me to generate quantitative data, but I'm equally interested in your responses to the part of the survey where I ask for stories you can share about using this video to educate yourself and others, drive Microsoft 365 adoption, or achieve other personal or organizational objectives. You can find a link to this anonymous survey in the transcript and resources guide, or simply visit aka.ms/m365update survey in your favorite web browser. Thanks in advance for your help in shaping the future of how we bring you Microsoft 365 news. Now, on to the updates. I covered the release of Editor and PowerPoint to Office Insiders in the November 2018 Microsoft 365 update. Editor underlines potential issues with spelling in red, grammar in blue, and style in gold. And right-clicking on the underlying text reveals suggestions on how to resolve the matter. At the time, it worked best with U.S. English. Now, Editor and PowerPoint helps you break down language barriers with the addition of multi-language support. This enhancement provides the correct guidance even if multiple languages are used on the same slide. Here we have a PowerPoint list in four different languages: English, French, Spanish, and German. PowerPoint recognizes the language being used for each item, applies the appropriate rules, and suggests fixes for each in the correct language. In this case, each line contains a grammatical error as evidenced by the words with the double blue underline. I'll just right-click on each and take the suggestion where it offers. Of course, I could use the translate feature to make sure the suggestion is correct, like I'm showing here. Those running on the Office Insider release cadence should be on the lookout for support for this functionality to roll out soon. Icons are a great way to express ideas visually, and they're simple to insert into your Microsoft Office documents. What I really like about icons in Office is, once in place, you can rotate, resize, and recolor them without any loss in the quality of the image. You can also separate the icon into its components and use only the pieces you want. There are nearly 350 new icons to choose from in Office 365. They include categories like accessibility, holidays, and process. I first covered the powerful app with the funny name Microsoft Kassala back in August of 2018. It enables you to securely connect and engage with large groups outside your organization's directory, including contract workers, vendors, partners, and customers. It uses a phone number-based identity for easy onboarding and to create a simple mobile user experience. We made a few Kassala-related announcements on April 4th, including, first, Kassala is rolling out to all eligible Microsoft 365 and Office 365 commercial customers worldwide. Second, we plan to bring Kassala capabilities into Microsoft Teams over the next 12 to 18 months. Finally, a bunch of new capabilities were also announced, including app mentions, a Kassala web app for managers and admins, and video calling. Get started by downloading Kassala from the iOS or Android store. One of the most innovative and unique features introduced in Power BI over the last 12 months is the Web by Example connector. It allows customers to scrape data from HTML pages. It supports ingesting any data element on the page beyond just HTML tables. You provide sample values for what data you would like to be extracted, and it does the rest. This month, we're taking another paradigm-shifting step with this connector. We're making the connector's AI algorithm even smarter so it can now automatically suggest Power BI tables based on HTML element repetition patterns. After enabling the new preview feature from the Options dialog, suggested tables are exposed in a new folder within the Web Connector Navigator dialog. This removes the requirement to provide sample output values in many common scenarios. This is but one of the dozens of new or updated features in the April release of the Power BI Desktop. You can find all the information you need to learn more in the Transcript and Resources Guide. Compliance Manager makes it easy to manage your organization's cloud compliance activities from implementation to reporting. It now allows you to create custom risk assessments of any application used in your organization. This customized assessments capability enables IT to import their own security and compliance controls into Compliance Manager, including those for corporate policy, local law, and industrial standards. Organizations can then create risk assessment tiles for on-premises services and non-Microsoft assets and manage their compliance posture in one place. Email message encryption helps ensure that only intended recipients can view message content. With Office 365 message encryption, your organization can send and receive encrypted email messages between people inside and outside your organization. It works with Outlook.com, Yahoo, Gmail, and other email services. Office 365 Advanced Message Encryption enables admins to revoke or expire encrypted emails. Once an encrypted email has been revoked, the recipient attempting to open it will be notified that the message has been revoked by the sender and be unable to view it. More and more governments, third-party regulators, and corporate compliance groups are enacting data residency guidelines. MultiGeo helps multinational companies address their regional, industry, or organizational data residency requirements in Office 365 by enabling them to control where each employee's Office 365 data is stored when at rest. SharePoint Online and Office 365 groups join Exchange Online and OneDrive in enabling customers to control where sites, in the case of SharePoint, and group mailboxes, in the case of Office 365 groups, are stored. Now, IT doesn't need to worry about running separate file, content management, or email servers in the regions your organization operates. Your users are free to work across geographies, and you have peace of mind knowing your data at rest is stored in the location that meets your requirements. Office Security Policy Advisor is a new intelligence service, now available in preview, that uses behavior-based analysis to help IT admins to quantify the risks and benefits of applying a tailored policy and monitor policy health over time for their Office clients. Admins can now deploy policies with a single click and easily update or even roll back policies. Together, these capabilities help IT admins streamline their policy workflow and management. Once again, this service is now available in preview for all organizations with Office 365 Pro Plus. The links needed to get started are in the Transcript and Resources Guide. Azure AD Password Protection, now generally available, lowers the risk of being compromised by what is commonly known as a password spray attack. This is when a malicious user attempts to use a single, easy-to-guess password against multiple accounts before moving on to the next commonly used password. The updated banned password algorithm uses both the Microsoft-defined global banned password list and the custom banned password list you define to help users avoid choosing weak and vulnerable passwords. In this demo, I'm signed into the Azure portal with a global administrator account. I'll click on Authentication Methods to get to the password protection page. You see the custom banned password list I've configured for my tenant. Recommendations on what to include here are words specific to your organization, such as products, trademarks, industries, cities, and even local sports teams. Once password protection is enabled, this list will be fed into the banned password algorithm and used to minimize your organization's exposure to hackers. The result is Azure AD Password Protection now blocks a wider range of easily guessable passwords. That's it for this month. As always, to get the most out of this update, be sure to check out the transcript and resources guide at aka.ms/m365update-blog. It includes the complete talk track and links to content I used to create this video, a list of roadmap-related resources, and a reference of YouTube links to topics from past videos. And I'll close with one final request. Please respond to our questionnaire at aka.ms/m365update survey. I'm Jim Narosky. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon.